Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got issues 107 and 108. Yes, a Spitfire diorama. There's not a great lot to do in these, to be honest. Let's have a look at the overhead. There we go. Issue 107, we get a mechanic and a ladder. Excellent. Got a weird looking face. There we go. Put two struts to the ladder and that is it basically. And then you can pop him on the ladder as well. And then a quick look at the magazine. Getting married in wartime. World War II did not stop people getting married. In fact, quite the contrary. The government decided to offer advice to couples wanting to tie the knot, and these photographs are part of the work of the Ministry of Information to help plan weddings despite the constraints of wartime. Well, she looks happy enough. There we go. Next page, the Arnhem reversal. Spitfire units became embroiled in the doomed Allied Operation Market Garden offensive to seize key bridges in the Netherlands. Cracking film as well. Lots of good actors on it. And in the main page, Wing Commander Johnny Johnson, wing leader of number 127 Squadron, and his dog Sally had advanced landing ground B-26 Ilias in Normandy a few months before Operation Market Garden. And another couple of pictures here, the Spitfire 9, and both Spitfire 9s actually. Excellent stuff. That'll be good reading. Nicely read this magazine yet. And on this page, number 416 Squadron of the Royal Canadian Air Force flew six different marks of Spitfire during its 4 years of service as part of the RAF. And here we have the aircrew from number 416 Squadron in front of a CF-100 Canuck in February 1957, shortly after the unit had moved to St. Hubert near Montreal. And picture number two, a Spitfire Mark 16 of number 416 Squadron flying from Evere in Belgium in early 1945. Excellent stuff. And here we have more of the Japanese campaign. Philippines Air Campaign. The Philippines were liberated from Japanese occupation in a series of bloody campaigns supported by US Army, Navy and Marine Aviation. That's General Doug MacArthur. And USS Pennsylvania, a Colorado-class battleship with three cruisers before the landing on Luzon in January 1945. It's very impressive. That goes on for a few more pages. Excellent stuff. And here we have, coming in issue 108, wheels, tyres and hubcaps for the right side of the tractor, together with a fire extinguisher and assorted screws. Lovely job, boy. There we are, that's the box for 107. Let's get them open. Excellent bit of detail there. It doesn't look as weird. His eyes don't anyway. It focusing. There we go. Oh, I don't like too bad. In the picture it looks a bit weird. Nice green uniform as well. Excellent stuff. Okay, let's get the ladders out. Okie dokie. You can see where these go already. They'll go here. A clip in place, and then there's two pegs, small pegs there and there, and likewise on there. I think that's where that goes, like that. That will go like that, and we'll just clip them in place. Well, we'll have to glue them in place anyway. Okay, let's put a dab of glue on there. Now this will go on this way. Put that on there like that. Just like that. I'll do the same for the other side. There we go, that's all the parts glued. That was a really quick issue. And there we go, there's our wee man on the ladders. Excellent stuff. Brilliant. Let's move on to issue 108. Here we go. Issue 108. Wheels, hubcaps and fire extinguisher. Now, if I'm remembering rightly, we didn't need any hot water for the tyres last time, so we'll try it again without hot water. There we go. Couple of tyres onto the tractor, I think, and then we've got the hubcaps to put in place and a fire extinguisher, and we can put our WAF back in place. Excellent. So that'll be that completed. And on the next page, move into Burma with the lifting of the siege of Imphal and the effective defeat of Japanese air power. Spitfire units roamed over Burma in support of Allied ground forces chasing the retreating enemy. In the main picture, we have a Spitfire Mark 8 of number 155 squadron. Picture number 2, another Spitfire Mark 8 from 155 squadron over Palau in October 1944. And in this picture, we have Flight Officer Whit Witteridge advises Spitfire Mark 8 LV-678 at Palau in September 1944. Excellent stuff. And here we have, he must be an ace, this guy, Johnny Checkitz. During operations on the Channel front, Kiwi ace Johnny Checkitz downed 14 German fighters while flying a Spitfire. Excellent stuff. Squadron leader Johnny Checkitz in front of a well-weathered Spitfire in early 1944 when he was an instructor at the Central Gunnery School at Sutton Bridge in Lincolnshire. We'll look forward to reading this one. And here we have a Spitfire VB W3528 of number 485 squadron alongside other Spitfires on the airfield at Kenley in February 1942. The panels fit alright. On our next page, Operation Borden Platt. On New Year's Day 1945, the Luftwaffe made a last-ditch effort to destroy Allied air power on the continent, but the cost outweighed the damage it caused. I do remember that. Very much so. Picture number 2, German Luftwaffe officials and pilots at a military air base in Belgium prior to an attack on Allied airfields. And number 3, 7 of the 131 wing Spitfires force landed due to damage or lack of fuel during the air battle. This Spitfire Mark 9 of Polish 308 squadron was among the casualties. That goes on four pages, so that'll be another cracking read. Excellent. And then next set of parts, figurine of an RAF officer with stickers for his feet and two parts of another ladder. Oh, he isn't going to be sat in situ. No way. Anyway, let's have a look at the parts. And here we have the parts in the box. Excellent stuff. Okay, let's fit the tyres. Let's see if this, how supple this is. You never know. That was a lot tougher than I expected. See if this one was any better. Get that on the inside. No need for water there. Okay, now we need the tractor. Here we have the tractor. So basically, this goes on there, does it? Is it that way? Yep. Goes on that way. Whoops, and we need a PWB screw. That's better. is this one. And now we need that one, so we need a smaller screw for this one. Okay, now we put the tires in place, we need to put the hubs on. These super glue on, they push fit, and then once you push them in place you can super glue them. And then just left with the extinguisher, and then we can put our WAF in place. So let's have a look at that. So there we go, that's the hubs in place. The front two are glued in, the back two are just pushed into place. Excellent. I've still got a bit of a wobbly wheel. Let's do the extinguisher. So there's our WAF in place, looking brilliant. And again, and there is the extinguisher, that's just pushed in place, doesn't need to be glued in. You can do if you want to, it's entirely up to yourself. There we go, got a bit of a wobbly wheel there, but not to worry, it's not going to be moving much. And there we are, that is issue 107 and 108 complete. Lovely jubbly, excellent stuff. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. There they both are, looking absolutely brilliant. Like I said, that has got a bit of a wobbly wheel, that one. It's screwed incorrectly, but it just is what it is. And there's our little man. He looked brilliant. His eyes aren't weird. I looked at it in the instructions. Anyway, that is it for today. 107 complete. Only have 109 and 110 left to do. So that'll be on my channel at a later date. But anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.